Shalom, Chevra. It is amazing to have this medium of technology to be able to communicate with all the Chevra. That even though we can't actually see each other and our shuls are closed, we're still able to communicate. And in fact, we can actually get closer to each other more than ever now. So, you know, Corona's locked us up. We're all unable to go to shul and so much of our lives is turned upside down, and it's amazing and incredible. And it's at a time like this where we need to talk about bitachon, about trusting God, about the ability to let go. So we were discussing it in the previous drops from the well, how Yosef HaTzadik was a guy who was capable of so much, so talented. And yet he finds himself for 12 years in a dungeon. And instead of getting down about it, he switched his mode of thinking and he said, okay, so there's two ways that God operates with us. Sometimes you're supposed to do stuff and sometimes you're supposed to feel helpless. And the feeling of helplessness is itself the greatest, most empowering force you could ever imagine. The feeling of helplessness means that the Chovas Halvavos says that a person should feel as if he's in a dungeon and only God can help me. So he relies on God completely and utterly. It's just submission. And that's what we have now, the avoider of Corona, is the ability to let go. So let's talk about this whole notion of letting go. The Tzemach Tzedek said that Bitachon is called Tracht gut v'tzayim gut. Think good and it will be good. A few days ago when Corona first locked us up, first began, so I sent out a message, and it was, you know, that you got to think good and it'll be good. And a couple of people sent me back a question, and they said, how can you say that? How do you know it's going to be good? Now, let's understand, there's a big difference between emuna and bitachon. Emuna means I'm 100% in the power of God. I believe in God, I trust Him, I feel His presence. But I don't necessarily know for a fact that things are going to be good. Maybe God doesn't want them to be good. Bitachon is the opposite. Bitachon is a confidence. It's 100% sure. I know it's going to be good. That's what the Pasuk says. We say this every time we take out the Torah on Yom Tov. We say the Pasuk, V'abiteach ba'ashem chesed yisevevenu from Tehillim. He who trusts God, he who has perfect faith in God, the kindness encompasses him. But actually, you actually feel the power. The kindness actually comes down to you. So these people asked the question. They said, just one second. Are you saying that if something bad, God forbid, happened, does that mean that I didn't have bitachon? Because, you know, what if I do have bitachon? Very often, we have bitachon and it doesn't work. And then what? So let me explain just my humble opinion about what this means, what this Tracht gut v'tzayim gut means. What it means is this. Yeah, when someone's sick, so you go to a doctor and you ask the doctor to heal him. When you need money, you go work. Those are the channels through which the parnassah, the health, comes down. So there's another channel, and it's called bitachon. You can't employ this channel for everything. You can't live forever because you have bitachon. So I'm sure, I'm confident I'll live forever. I'm not sure that's going to work. Maybe if you were able to focus on it completely all the time without letting go for a moment, maybe you could live forever. Possibly. I don't know. But you know what bitachon means? Bitachon is that I know 100% for a fact, okay? I know it's going to be good. Now, let's understand, when do you employ this force in your being? It's when you feel negative thoughts and feelings and emotions, that's when you need to employ it. So you're sitting by and it's Corona season and you're lost and you're sitting over there just worried, what's going to be, how am I going to live, where's my parnasa, where's my livelihood going to come from? I feel helpless completely, and all these negative thoughts start gushing into your mind. That is the moment for Tracht gut v'tzayim gut. That's the moment for thinking good. And at this point, you're called upon to shift your thinking. Eoiv says, Pachad pochadati vayesoyeni. I thought bad thoughts, and that's what happened. It becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy, meaning what God did is He empowered us, the same as doctors have the power to heal, and money has, and money comes from working. So too, good things come from bitachon. When there's a negative experience, a negative thought that comes your way, you're empowered to shift it in your thinking. And when you shift it, you can actually change things for good. That's the power of bitachon. Does that mean necessarily that everything's going to be good? Everything? I don't know. It means that what you thought about now, what you were able to draw down, you're drawing down the power of good. The more good you feel, the better it's going to become. Right? So let me clarify that. It will be good. If you think it's going to be good, it's going to be good. But not everything can you think about. So when you have the power to think, that allows you to draw down the good. And when is it supposed to be used? At moments when you feel down. So your head goes crazy. Your head starts thinking all sorts of negative thinking. And that's when you're called upon to shift it. And that power to shift it, you're drawing down the positive forces. So the negative forces are trying to penetrate this world through your mind. And the key here is to understand that we are empowered by God to be participants in the process. We're not just staring at something that's happening and saying, well, I don't know, maybe, you know, what's my thinking going to have to do with anything? God says, your thinking is powerful. Your thinking is going to change things. So if it came out that it didn't work out, that just means it wasn't something you were able to think about. But in real time, when you have that negative thinking, that's when you're called upon. So how do I know it's going to be good? Because I'm thinking it's going to be good. That power itself is the power to make things good. There's this beautiful episode in Tanakh about Chizkiyo. He was this most powerful king, and one day he's on his deathbed. And the prophet Yeshayahu comes to him and he says, the reason is because you sinned. Because he didn't want to have children. So he says, as a result, Hashem has decreed upon you to pass away. And Yeshayahu says, thank you very much for the prophecy. And this is a prophecy of a prophet in Jerusalem. So it's 100% supposed to be something that's meant to come about. And you can imagine that Chizkiyahu's mind is flooded with all negative thinking. And he switches mode and he forces himself and he says, no, God. And he davened to Hashem and he says, Afilu cherev chada munachas al tzavorei shel adam. Even if there's a sword, a sharp sword on a person's neck, al yimna atzmoi min harachamim, never should he prevent himself from compassion. And he says, God, I love you. God, help me. And suddenly the bitachon worked. And he is able to, the Navi comes to him after and he says, as a result of your tefillah and your bitachon, you were able to draw down 15 more years of precious life. That's the avodah of Corona. It's the avodah of when we are placed in this position of helplessness and we feel anxiety, to shift our anxiety into bitachon, confidence. 100% to know that through my thinking, tracht gut wird sein gut, God will make it good in a revealed way.